my topic of my presentation is communication networks and safeguards. So before going to start my topic, I want to give you the outline that what we will are going to learn today. So I will start my first topic is how analog and digital signals differ. And secondly, I will discuss about the networks. So what are the concept of network, its types, and how wireless and wired media are used in networking. And finally, I will discuss how computer can be made secure from intruders like cyber threats, hackers, and safeguards. So I will begin my topic with the introduction of analog to digital signals. So let's see. So you know that computer use digital signals. Everything the data is processed in computer is in the form of zero and ones. So everything we process in digital form. So each bit we can say that you can see that each bit in computer is in the form of one and zero. But if we talk about the analog signal, so in real life every phenomena is analog signals like sound, light, temperatures are the examples of analog signals. Analog signals use wave variations. So traditional TV and radio is an example of analog signal. As you see, and one of the best example of analog signal is human eyes also operates in analog mode. So for analog to digital conversion, the analog digital analog signals can be converted into a digital form. So how we convert analog digital signals into analog signals? So for data transmission over long distance using cables or wires, so we use the analog to digital converters like modems are needed to convert analog and digital into digital forms. Modem is short for modulate and demodulate. Modems modulate convert a computer digital to analog data, transmit it, and modulate, reconvert it back to digital data for receiver computers. So modem can convert data by either using the frequency or amplitude of an analog signal. So I will give you the diagram so how this conversion is possible. So you can assume this is a computer A and this is a computer B. So data is transferred from computer A to computer B through the modems. So modem works like it converts digital data into analog. You can see this digital data is converted into analog form. And the receiver side, demodulation. Demodulation means reverse back the analog signals back to digital form. After receiving it, the same signal will be in the digital form. This is a simple conversion of digital to analog. This is the concept of modem. So modulation can be achieved by frequency or amplitude. This is the, you can see this is the frequency of a signal. This is the analog signal. Now amplitude, what is the amplitude? Amplitude is a height of the signal, and frequency is a number of vibrations per second. So we can use either frequency or amplitude for modulation. If we take the frequency of the signal represents one, and it stays the same to represent one. If there is a changing, there will be a one. Otherwise, it will be zero. Like amplitude, if we take the amplitude modulation, now we are taking the amplitude, not the frequency. The same process will be done here. Okay? Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So sampling, there's another term called sampling. When we convert analog to digital convert, we use sampling mechanism like tape recorder, voices, and musical instruments are analog. CDs are, you know, CDs,
yes,
compact discs are digital. So to buy a CD, to record a data on a CD, a digital recording equipment must convert from analog to digital. Okay? The analog to digital converts samples. At each cycle, it takes some samples, some points for conversion into digital form and converts the height of the wave to a number. The sample of the sounds are taken as regular intervals about 44,100 times 8 seconds. So, because the digital samples are played back faster than our eyes can react, it sounds like a continuous stream of wave. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So, one of the best example of sampling is you are showing movies. So, movies show still picture. What do you think about movies?
Pixels.
So actually, it's the combination of pictures. Movies are, but they show them so fast that our eyes cannot react because the process is very fast. So, to us, the series of still pictures looks like a continuous motion. So, my second topic is computer network. Anybody know about the computer network?
Yes, sir.
What do you know about computer network?
The sharing information.
Sharing information. Other thing we can do with computer networks? Yes, you. Okay, let's see what's the computer network. So, what's a computer network? A system of interconnected computer, telephones or other devices that can communicate with each other to share applications and data. And simple way, we can say that a computer, if two or more computers are connected together, is called a computer network. Whereas, the concept of connecting these components is called networking. So, somebody who is very expert in a network, he will be a network administrator. He is doing some kind of networking.
Yes, sir.
So, this is a diagram of network. You see, this is a network component, computers. So, benefits, what are the benefits? There are many benefits of a computer network, like share peripheral devices such as printer, scanner, disks, and share programs, better communication like email, security of information. You can back up your data by using computer network and access to shared resources. You can see from this diagram, this provides security information as a reservation and preservation, sharing software, sharing files, sharing information, sharing everything can be achieved by using computer network. So, what are the types of computer network? So, these are the categories of computer network, like wide area network covers a large geographical area, like your world wide web is a WAN type of WAN, wide area network. When you are on WWW, you are connected on WAN. So, metropolitan area network, which covers a city like a Karachi, we are in Karachi. So, if we make a metropolitan area network, so we use WAN, okay, or sub, okay, then we have local area network. Connects computer and device in a limited geographical area, like any building, any school, like in our university, we have a LAN setup, local area network.
Say our
home. Or homes, you can make limited, which is not so long network, so we called it local area network. And other one is HAN, home area network, use wires, cable, wireless connections to link a household digital device. If you have a Wi-Fi in your home, you can connect to your all devices.
Yes, sir.
So, personal area network PAN uses short range wireless technology to connect individual personal electronics. Suppose we are here, we want to make a personal area network. How will we make? Do you have any idea? By using cell phones, by using Bluetooth, we can make a personal area network. We can share files within a limited short range distance. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So, how networks are structured? So, there are structured mechanism. We have two principles. The one is client server. The server is a one which provides shared resources to other computers. The client is a computer which access shared resources. We can make a server, like if you put all of your data in a one computer, it's like your file server, or you can make a database server which record your all the activities of your data. Print server, we can assign a role to any computer which can print the jobs for other computers. Means everyone can print the job from print server, or we can have mail server. So server is nothing, it is assigned a role. It can provide the shared resources, yes, like mail server, which hosts the email accounts for the user. Yeah, internet is a wide area network, but you can make your own network. Like I told you that we can make local area network. For this, if you want to have a print server or mail server, the simplest one is to make your own computer, put your data and share with other computer. This is called your file server. Server is nothing. The word is a little big, look like a big, but server is a computer, okay? So one model is peer to peer. Peer means colleague, like there's no difference between the boss and servants. If someone is giving, if it is sharing, if I talk about computers, if you are sharing your files with other computers, at that time you are server, the one is client, and vice versa. Okay? All computer networks are equal. And communicate directly with another without relying on server. You can see, so all computers, you and other computers are peers. They are friends, like friends. They share data with each other without assigning a centralized role. Like we cannot say here is a server, here is a client. Both are equal. Is it clear?
Yes, yes, sir.
So network infrastructure, so we have intranet, extranet and VPN. So intranet is the private network accessible only to a organizational staff. Understand? A company which set up their own network within their company network, it's called intranet. Then extranet, similar to an intranet, but the organization can communicate with vendors, clients outside the internet. This is within the company. This is outside the company network. And VPN, do you know about VPN, virtual private network? A virtual private network is a network technology that creates a secure network connection over a public network. If you want to secure your data from the, because when you are on the internet, you are on public network. You want to make a tunnel where only your data can be transported through a secure channel. That we call a virtual private network. So what are the network components? You know about the protocols, linking devices. A protocol defines the rules and conventions for communication between devices. This is called protocol. The example is TCP. IP, Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol, and UDP, User Datagram Protocol. So routers. So when you are communicating on the World Wide Web, the router transport your data.
Yes.
This is called route. So perform the traffic directing function. Which route is the best for fastest communication? This router decide. Okay? And how the common connection point for devices on a network has multiple ports and can send all the connected devices. And switch is like hub, but it is more intelligent. It will send data only to the intended recipient. But hub is not intelligent. It will broadcast all the data. If someone has to receive the data, he will say, okay, this is my data. Otherwise, we will use the switch, which is a more intelligent. And bridge interface that connect the same type of network. And other one is gateway interface that connect dissimilar network. I will show you the diagram. You can see every device is like bridge, router is used in a networking. If you want to if you are on wide area network, so every component is used. So you know about these terms now, hub, switch, router.
Yes, sir.
So another topic, the subtopic of network is network topology. So physical arrangement of a layout of computer is called topology, like this seating arrangement of your class seating arrangement. So how computers are arranged in a network. So many types of topology are bus topology. The simplest one is a bus, where all computers are connected through a single wire. And ring all nodes are connected in a continuous loop. And star all nodes are connected through a central host, like a switch. So you see the diagram of bus topology. Here you see the only single wire is used to connect all the devices. And this is a ring topology. You can see the only ring is shaped to connect all the computers. Like take this ring as a cable. And this is a star topology. You can see this is a centralized server. If you connect your servers to client, this is a forms a star topology. Or this can be here a switch or hub you can put here. This will make a star topology. So what topology do you see in our computer lab? Do you have any?
Bus
topology?
Yes, sir.
Anyone?
Star, sir, star.
We have a, yes.
Star, sir, star.
They are very good. So we use most of the time our network is structured on star topology. We have a centralized server, or we can say centralized switch that connects all the computers. So wired communication media, this is also a subtopic of network. So we categorize network into wired and wireless. So in wired, we have twisted pair wires, like two strands of insulated copper wire twisted around each other. You can see this is a coaxial cable, this is a twisted cable. You can see this diagram? This is a thread, like thread mechanism. Twisting, what's the purpose of twisting? Twisting reduces interface, crosstalk. It reduces the noise between the signals. So data rates are 1 to 128 megabits per second, and we have coaxial cable. You know, coaxial cable is commonly used in cable television. So we have insulated copper wires wrapped in a metallic shield and then in an external plastic cover used for cable TV and cable. Electric signals carries voice and data up to 200 megabits per second. The speed is much better than than twisted pair cable. And while communication continue, we have fiber optic cable. Do you know about fiber optic? This is the one of the best invention in networking. Fiber optical cable is network cable that connects standards of glass fiber. It's used glass concept. You can see this diagram. This is a strands of glass. They are designed for long distance, very high performance data networking. And telecommunication compared to wired cable, fiber optic provides higher bandwidth and can transmit data over long distance. Most of our today's network is based on fiber optic. So in Ethernet, if we talk about local area network, we use twisted pair cable, which is provided in category 5, 6. It depends upon the bandwidth that it supports. So connect PC Ethernet network interface card through NIC, network interface card. You know, we have in computer, we have network interface card, and for several PCs, get a hub or switch to connect them all. The speed of the LAN, if you want to make a local network, the speed is 10 to 100 megabits per second. This is about LAN network. And about that subtopic, the wireless communication media, we have radio frequency. We transmit through the air medium. So radio frequency spectrum is a part of electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic spectrum is a range of frequencies which falls on a particular channel that carries more signals, like we have electric wave, radio waves, infrared, visible light, ultraviolet, X-ray, gamma rays, cosmic rays. So this is a spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum. This is a kilo, it starts from kilohertz to gigahertz. So this is the range of frequency that falls upon a particular channel. So bandwidth, if you talk about wireless bandwidth, what's the bandwidth of frequencies, range of frequency that a transmission medium can carry in a given period of time. So analog bandwidth is measured in hertz. And the digital bandwidth usually in bits per second. If we measure the bandwidth of analog and digital, the units are different, okay. So narrow band for, this is used for voice band, used for regular telephone communications, transmission rate 1.5 megabits per second or can be less. And broadband for high speed data and high quality audio and video transmission. Now we are using broadband connectivity in our homes. Transmission rate is much higher, 1.5 megahertz per second to 1 gigahertz per second, or it can be more, depends upon the channel capacity you want to want. So wireless media types, we have also types of wireless media, as we discussed the wired types. So we have infrared transmission, send signal using a infrared light. You know about infrared? This is the concept of infrared, the one I am using. Pointer. Frequency are too low to see, 1 to 16 megabits per second, and broadcast radio, the other one is AM, amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, cell phones, police radio, these are the types, send data over long distance using a transmitter and receiver up to 2 megabits per second. So the other one is, the third one is cellular radio, forms of broadcast radio. Widely used in cell phones and wireless modems, transmit voice and digital messages. The fourth one is microwave radio, super high frequency radio waves, 2.54 gigahertz or higher require line of sight communication. You know the line of sight, both the receiver and the transmitter must be aligned together, otherwise if they are not aligned the communication will not take place, okay. More than half of the today telephone system use microwave technology radio. Communication satellites, microwave relay stations in orbit around the earth, you know there are many satellites which are orbiting around the earth. If you want to cover a large geographical area, then we use satellite communication, covers broad service area. So the last topic is cyber threats, hackers and safeguards. So how we can make our computers from intruders, from hackers. So first of all, I will discuss you what's the purpose of internet, what was the aim to invent internet, anyone? So the main purpose was invention of computer is to make collaboration with other universities for research. What was the purpose? The main purpose, they trusted each other. The internet is open access, you know, everyone can access, and used by criminals who take advantage of lack of built-in safeguards. So if you are on internet, maybe someone is stealing your data. So no security was built when internet was invented. So what are the measurements we can take to safeguard our computers, like cyber threats? So the one is denial of service attacks. You can see from this diagram, these are the actual users, the blue one are actual users, and these are the attackers. They want to target this server. So consists of making repeated requests of a computer network, that thereby overloading and denying the legitimate user. They want that we are the actual user and target the computer and corrupt their data, used to target particular companies or individuals. This is called denial of service attacks. Cyber threats, we have worm, malware, a program that copies itself repeatedly into a computer memory or disk, may copy itself so much it crashes the infected computer. Primary target PC running Microsoft Windows. This is the most common in Microsoft Windows operating system. You can find many worms. Day to day you have problem of viruses, worms. And viruses, another malware is deviant program that resides on a disk in an email or in a web link that causes unexpected effects such as destroying or corrupting your data. Viruses are released at the rate of about 1 per day. So to see what the latest one are, you can follow the link semantic.com. Another one is Trojan horses, program that pretend to be a useful program, like they can come up in a package. You see, this is a valuable program, but it contains a malware.
Yes,
so what are the measurements we can, or what are the key elements the viruses are spread via email attachment, by infected disk, by clicking on the unfiltered website, by downloading infected file from website through unfiltered Wi-Fi spot, and from one PC to another PC when you are connected on an internet. So viruses spread is through these. So what are the cyber villains if we talk about hackers? So hackers are either computer enthusiasts, people who enjoy learning about programming and computers, people who gain unauthorized access to other computers. Two types, thrill seeker hackers do it for challenge. If someone is giving a challenge, okay, hack this computer, so he will do for you. And one is white hat hackers do it to expose security flaw that can be the one who is protecting the security.
He's ethical hacking.
Yeah, ethical hacking, very good. So this is illegal, the one is legal, who is checking the security measure. So malicious hacker who break into the computers for malicious purpose, we have categories. We have crackers like this, script kiddies, technically unsophisticated teenagers who use downloadable software. There are many available software by using you can enter others' computers. So this kind of is a scripting. You can download program scripts, and hacktivist, hacker activist who break into a system for a political purpose. Black hat hackers, those who break into the computer to steal or destroy information or to use it for illegal profit. Cyber terrorists attack computer system as to bring physical or financial harm to group, company or even nations. So how can you make your computer more secure? So there are online safety available. You can use antivirus software, install a firewall, block your incoming request by using some kind of softwares. Don't use the same password for multiple sites, and don't give password out any information. Use robust password, like minimum 10 characters, which contain letters, number,
symbols.
This is a kind of security. So another security is biometric. You can make your computer through biometric science of measuring individual body characteristics used in security, like hand, fingerprint recognition, iris recognition, face detection. Yes, so we can use both, like voice recognition.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now available also in your laptop. Yes. It's available in your computer.
Yeah,
even in mobile phones. So another one is encryption. This is a safeguard technique. So process of altering readable data into unreadable form to prevent unauthorized access uses powerful mathematical ciphers to create coded messages that are difficult to break. Unencrypted messages are known as plain text, and encrypted text is known as ciphered text. Either private keys or public keys are used to encrypt and send and then receive the decrypt message. This is an example. So the computer one sent hello. This will encrypt this into another format. This is called cipher text. And at the receiver end, it will de-encrypt. The de-encryption will take place, the same information, the hello will be sent. By using a public key, you will put an other information like lock, you will give your key for this. Okay. So thank you. This was all about my today's lecture. So any question you can ask me.
No, sir.
So in the next class we will discuss about the operating system and its types. Okay. Thank you, all of you.